Hello everyone and welcome to the final episode of the Dutch Petting Zoo. And today we're gonna do a tour around this beautiful project. And of course, I'm joined again by the wonderful Jurre.
Hallo, hey.
There he is. See, yes. A lot of noise, that's Jurre. yeah, you can already see the beautiful park. And we're going into Tedget Camp to take you on a tour around the Dutch Petting Zoo. So we're gonna switch to that right now. So boom, there we are. Welcome into Tedget Camp. And of course, we are starting this tour at the pond.
Yeah,
we just arrived. From the other side of the water. There's our car. And
Why is the car facing that way?
We drove into the pond backwards.
Backwards, yeah. Because we needed to leave again, and we're like looking forward.
Yeah, yeah. if we are in a hurry, we can immediately leave. So this is the beautiful pond that Jurre created. We still don't know why he did this. Oh yeah, there is actually a pond in this area.
Yeah,
For the people who don't know this project, it's a little recreation. It's not really a recreation, but
loosely inspired by
Slot Loevestein.
Yeah. Yes,
in the Netherlands. That's why it's the Dutch Petting Zoo. Okay, so the pond. Yeah, not much to say about the pond.
You know what's funny?
Think about the pond.
No. Yes, I was watching some news item about a mechanic, and you know what his workplace was? This exact ferry, same color, and I was like, whoa, they copied me from that episode. They built a ferry like I did.
Ah, yeah.
And so I saw the insides as well. And,
Oh. Did you change it? Did you make an interior?
Yeah, there's not dead animals in there.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Veerboot, which is a ferry. Dutch for pond, ferry. And let's continue this way.
Wow.
And we can walk around and see some cows. There should be some cows.
Oh, there they are.
Oh, yeah, beautiful. We will have some. You can already imagine, walking here in the Dutch countryside.
Everything smells like manure. Oh,
yes. Delicious. Old people on electrical bicycles.
Yeah.
I can already imagine it.
And a super stressed delivery guy.
Yeah.
Yep.
Beautiful. This thing. We arrived at the gate. So this is the gate where the cows can cross the street towards the other side. There are some there's some cow friends over there. So if they want to meet up, they can cross the street right over here. And this thing is actually working. I don't know what
it opens. The
English.
Gate opens. Wow.
Yeah.
Is it animated? Yeah.
No, I mean, that thing. They can't cross this right now, so I don't know why we build a gate. But it works. But you will see that also in the rest of the park. I'm gonna remove my UI again. I'm not sure if I already did that, but let's continue.
Ruined.
Yeah, I ruined the entire video. There is a vet here.
She's lost, I guess.
Yeah. And you can already see one of the beautiful windmills on this side.
Very nice.
But we will come to that later. We're just gonna continue along this path. And what I like, because I visit this place. And normally there's a parking lot over there. And you will actually walk along this road.
Okay.
Towards the entrance. So we did a good job with that. It looks nice. And this is where the owner of the castle lives, I guess.
Why wouldn't he live in a castle? Like, he has a castle. Why would he live here?
But he lives here. I don't know.
Ah, interesting.
That makes no sense. Okay,
the
local
house,
farmer.
Though, yes.
Yeah, the local farmer lives here.
Yeah.
His name is Henk.
Henk.
And
that's my dad's name. That's weird because this is my house.
Yeah, I knew that.
Oh.
And Henk is a mechanic. Here he is.
Yeah.
But anyway, this is this house was inspired by something. You built this. Tell me something about this.
Yes. So my house looks like this, like where I live. And then this barn here isn't there. Because I'm not living. It used to be a farm, but now it isn't. But it still looks like it. Blah, 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 blah. And yeah, this is like I took a reference image. I looked for a dirty old barn in the Netherlands, and then this you got. Yes.
Yeah. That's this it. Looks like a dirty old barn.
Yeah. I can already like smell what it would smell like there. Ugh,
yeah,
like.
Because you will have poop here.
Yeah, damn.
Quite a lot. And a cow. Yeah. Yeah, they make a lot of noise.
Yeah.
I won't go inside because there's no interior.
Not quite.
But if you want to check out the inside yourself, this thing is on the workshop, of course.
Is this?
Yes, there's a link down in the description. And you can download it and give it a thumbs up, of course. Yeah, because we like thumbs ups.
Gives me dopamine, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything for the likes. Okay, so there was the farm. We didn't really arrive at the petting zoo yet. But yeah, we will come to that.
Now we're just trespassing.
Yeah, we will have a little backstage something. Another car. They should clean their car.
Well, it's the exact same old as our car. That's crazy. Oh.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. Oh, there's Hank again. Bye bye.
He's busy. He's broken.
Yeah. He's working hard on his farm. Let's see. Let's continue along the path. Yeah. Beautiful Dutch countryside, as you can see. Very interesting. Wow. Very interesting terrain work. Yeah.
There's lots of people hiking with a broom on their shoulders. That's quite a...
Yeah, that's quite weird.
Special.
That's something they do in the Netherlands.
Yeah, it's like a hobby. Broom walking, they call it.
Yeah.
Inspired by Nordic walking.
Yeah, we have broom walking.
Yeah, everything is super
clean. We are arriving at the entrance.
Oh.
Right now. You can put your bicycle here on the right. Because I don't know why, but people in the Netherlands like their bicycles. I don't. But yeah, it's something. And on the left, we have the entrance. But first, we have some other things to see. We have Friet van Piet.
Yeah.
And they have frikandellen. And this was actually made by Odicus. And he made a fish stand.
Oh, Odicus made it. I didn't know that.
Yes. Yeah, Mr. Odicus. He made a fish stand, but I didn't think a fish stand would fit. Because, yeah, I like friet and kroketten and frikandellen, which are Dutch snacks.
Lega.
Yeah, you have to put them in the frying pan. And if you walk in here, you can actually see. Oh, wait.
Oh, very agile.
Yeah, wait. Oh, let's cut this out. See, there we are. And he actually made some frying pans over here. They only had two. I made four of them. And I put some frikandellen in there. And I changed the text. Look at this. The beautiful sunrise. Or sundown, I think. And Friet van Piet.
Wow.
And for the Dutch people. Wie is in nou de snackbar? You will get it. Yeah. Okay. Let's switch into Tagitcam again.
Hey.
Miel Monteur. Okay, we're back in Tagitcam. And there's another boat. Because why not?
Why not, eh?
Yeah, so we have this beautiful freight ship over there. Oh, I can't really see it from here. We also have a pier. I think that's called a pier. I don't know. Yeah, but we have a freight ship.
I got feedback also that it's not low enough in the water. And then maybe that's one of the dislikers.
That's why. Okay. But if you like this boat, please leave a like in the workshop. And on this video, of course. Jure did a good job with another boat. He really likes boats.
Yes, I do.
Yeah. And we don't have boats in the game. So Jure made like three or four boats now, I think, in this game. You made a pirate ship. You made
pirate
this
ship,
boat.
This one.
And the ferry.
Yeah, and then a couple more on the coaster as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, I think it's time to visit the petting
zoo. Actual zoo, yeah.
And Of course, we will also do a quick overview in the end of everything. But we will go through it in Tagetcam first. And I thought of something. We also have a parking lot here. And I almost forgot to show you guys.
Why didn't we park there? Beautiful.
I don't know. Why did we walk all the way from?
Yeah, why did we all walk all the way, man?
Yeah, we could have gone by car. I don't know. And we also have a habitat right here. You can see this is a habitat gate with the fence. And you will enter, and you will have this beautiful water area.
Water.
And a windmill. Okay. Let's see. So, the story from the windmill was that the windmill owner has two dogs. Yeah, this one and that one. Really weird names. And, yeah.
Hey, this one.
Yes. And, yeah, we just wanted to add a windmill, of course. This one is also on the workshop. So, if you want a windmill in your own zoo, yeah, you can download it and put it in there. It's really easy. It's recolorable, so you can change the color of the windmill. And yeah, it's very nice.
What will we want?
I really like it. I it's still one of my favorite creations.
It does look very nice.
I'm an easy man. But yeah, really cool. It fits, of course. It's a Dutch petting zoo, so it needs a windmill. Right?
Yes.
Okay, let's say goodbye to this one and that one.
Hi.
Let's go to the entrance. Oh, all the way through here. We have a lot of grass and beautiful plants everywhere.
It's called
this
weed.
Is the biggest hill in the Netherlands. That's here.
Yeah. They put a flag on top.
That's the highest point. Continue. So, the entrance. So this is the entrance of the fortress. We have the Dutch flag on top of it. We already have the beautiful cannons.
Yeah.
Pointing towards us.
Still working.
Some broom walkers. And we're crossing the water. You changed the water color, right?
I did. It's a bit more dark now.
Yeah.
A bit more realistic.
It fits. Yes. It fits. Oh, let's go through the gate. Oh,
oh my god. Oh, shit.
Oh, and we entered the zoo. There you go. Oh, we forgot to put in guests. Well.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
No problem. We have some free roaming. What's happening?
I'm so afraid of peacocks. I wouldn't be able to walk here.
Peafowls. We have peafowls here. Yeah, I think peacocks is a weird word.
But that's what it's called as well, isn't it? Like,
I don't know. It sounds weird. We have peafowls free roaming along the park, and we made this this little thing so they can't cross this. But they are able to walk all the way down there and to the back of the castle as well. What do you want to show first? So you enter in this little... what is it?
I
don't know.
Burrow, no. What would you call this? Like,
I don't know.
Scorch? Yeah, no.
Yes. So it's like a village in the fortress, and there's some nice little Dutch houses, some rotten food.
We used to play here. With our little local marching band or concert band, we used to play here in not here, but like in the real version. There was like a little festival, and we were sitting under like a tent and a really nice atmosphere at the castle and stuff. It's a long time ago though, but remember that
it's
well.
It's really nice.
Yes.
You will recognize it if you will ever visit this place. Then.
Yeah.
And then there it is. The castle.
Wow.
Bom, bom, bom. Custom roofing by Yuray. Some screaming peafowls.
Looks quite bad, actually. Now I look back at it.
Yeah, I had the same thing with the houses. I was like, I could have done a bit more detail. But we made this like a year ago or something.
Yes, yeah, that was a long time.
Yeah, and of course we became a lot better at this game. In the meanwhile, I guess. Hopefully.
I just play Planko, man. Yeah.
Yeah. The problem with this game is that everything looks so clean and
shiny.
Nice. Yeah. And then,
especially for this castle, like I would have loved to add more texture. And with Team Decay items, we can do that. But like Plan Zoo, it's still a challenge to get the right look for that. But it's not too bad, you know. It looks like a castle, and I angled some of the walls a bit like off, so it looks a bit more sketchy, I guess. Still, yeah. I would, if I were to make this in Planet Coaster, it would look a bit more convincing. But this is Planet Coaster. So we do what we do.
Unfortunately. Yes. We made a beautiful...
No, don't go inside. Don't do it.
See, there are the staff buildings. That's nice. Oh, that's a weird noise. Okay. And on the right of the castle... We have some sheep.
Aren't those goats? No, they're sheep.
See, a sheep. I don't it was supposed to be a sheep.
Man.
I don't know. It's an Arctic sheep. What's it called? Doll sheep. See, doll they sheep. Are sheep. Yeah.
Live in the doll.
Yeah.
And all of them. It's a doll, so.
Yeah. We have a lot of them. Also inspired by the real life thing, they have a lot of sheep walking around here.
Yeah.
Lying down under the trees. There's a little tower here. I don't know why it's there, but it's there.
Is it in the real life? Is it there as well?
Yes, yes, yes. Okay. And there's actually a bunker on the back, but we didn't make that.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like a proper one, like a World War II, like a concrete one or like a brick one?
Brick one.
Okay, so actually...
Yes, old one. It was not made for nuclear bombs, only for cannons.
Ah.
And, yeah, let's see. We had the peafowls. We saw that one. We have these little market stands everywhere.
Nice.
So if you came here and you're like, ooh, I need a blanket, you can buy a blanket.
Wow.
Yeah.
Best blankets in the country.
Yes. We have a beautiful terrace here. Can sit here, have lunch, and enjoy the view. Another house.
Yep.
Very nice. We put these barrels everywhere because we like barrels. They are on the workshop. See the peafowls also walking here.
Okay.
Very nice.
That's how peafowls
say. Oh yeah, yes, of course. Yeah. And we have some warthogs. It's supposed to be like Dutch fat pigs or something. And wait, can I cross this? Yes. And they are they are living here. They have a mud bath, and they also have an indoor thing.
Looks like my bed.
Yeah. So this is where Jure sleeps.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's where his mother sleeps. And it's nice little structure here. It's not a... Yeah, I don't know. It's not a very interesting habitat itself. But that wasn't the point, right? I guess.
Nope. What was the point? I don't even know.
we wanted to add some animals in here. I think the idea that we had and the final thing don't really look anything.
I mean, for this part it was. I mean, we had like the idea of like having a more sizable zoo outside of the fortress or something, but then in the end we were like, nah, we put everything inside, it's better, it's more confined or something.
Yeah.
That's a nice
thing. And we didn't really have many like petting zoo animals. Of course, this was invented in the time before we had mods. So, we had to do it with the animals that we had, because right now you have like actual cows and horses and pigs. Yeah, there's everything. But I didn't use any mods yet. But yeah, we also have llamas. Beautiful. And I know everyone likes this area. Laat maar zitten. you can sit here on a llama. And you can watch the llamas.
With actually, have llamas living next to me now. Like, in real life.
Really?
Yeah.
Do they
spit? No. I mean, I don't go outside. I wouldn't know. But, like, there's, like, an empty house that's been... They built that in, like, 2005. And no one ever lived there. And now it's, like, extra pasture for the llama. So they can go inside.
That's nice. Yeah. We have llamas. Which are really cool. Really cool animals. With another... very cool. You can see it. He's like, yeah, I'm cool. And another windmill. Let's take a look at the windmill again. This one is green.
I like the green more, I think.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I thought it just needed something there. And then instead of making something new, I just put another windmill in there.
That's the spirit.
Yeah, exactly. What else did we do? We have... you can walk here. This is like... I've walked here. And it was raining.
Oh. So
maybe I should put some rain in here to make it more realistic. Can I do that? Yes.
Now it looks like it's proper Netherlands. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is better. So when I was walking here, it was like this weather. Rain. We have a lot of rocks here. I like this little trick.
Yeah, I'm going to use that as well now. Well, I've said that when you build it like 3 years ago as well.
You can walk around the entire park. From here, you will be on top of this. More rocks. Oh, you cannot cross it here. Oh, you just have to climb the fence. And then beautiful cannons. Yes. They look very good.
Actually do look good. I changed my mind.
Okay, good. Thank you. And this is a shelter thing for the sheep. You can put food in it. Well, in real life, you could have put food in it. And I didn't really make anything that looks like
jelly beans.
Yes, for example. And another path. So this path goes around the park.
Oh, yeah.
And you can see everything. It's very nice. Did we skip anything?
Nah, not really. Now we basically show everything. Well, you could show from the aerial view the shape of the.
Yeah, we're gonna go into the sky. Let's do that.
Wow, we gained superpowers. We can fly now.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
So we are in the sky now, and of course I already know what Jura wants to show us.
Yes, because this was a pain in the bum bum. To get the shaping of the star thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's alright. You can see it's like a point. And they used to build that so they can easily defend it from attackers from all angles and stuff, I guess. I don't really know, I'm just making stuff up, but it seems logical.
It's a part of the Dutch, Waterlinie. So it's actually something like a part of the country. Which they can completely flood when they want to, keep people out of their country. And it was last used in the Second World War.
Oh, really?
And they forgot they had airplanes, so Rotterdam was bombed anyway. But at least they tried. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, why am I laughing? That's horrible.
It's not funny.
No.
Anyway, yeah. So this is you see this very often in the Netherlands. You also have this in the bigger cities as well.
Oh,
but then they put houses everywhere.
Yeah, my local city, they have it as well, like in the center, like in the bus. That's like this.
Yeah.
That's cool. I really like that stuff.
We like our water. And as you can see, we have a lot of space left.
Yeah, so if you're really ambitious and want to... In your building in this map, you can do so.
You can build Amsterdam here, for example. Makes no
Belgium.
Sense because it's Belgium. Belgium.
Entirety of Belgium.
Yeah. Make some crappy roads.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is the overview. So we arrived over there with the pond. And then we had the House of Hank right there. The farm. Or we can take a closer look at Yuri's boat. As you can see, it's still going.
Yeah, it's not going very far. I think it's run on the
beach or something. It's stuck. Yeah. It's stuck over here. And beautiful terrain work here.
That's so bad.
Do we so already lazy. Know why? Deep these poles, yeah. We didn't really finish this side, but we made some really nice little views.
This looks nice. Yes.
Yeah. We also made Jure made a cinematic little video, and it's really nice. Yes. If you wake up in the morning and have some nice music, and you make sure to check that one out as well.
I would appreciate that. Yes.
Yes. Yes. And I think that was it, Jure.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay.
And now we're gonna do like
And we're gonna do like an emotional goodbye, like the end of this collab. And we will never speak to each other ever again, right?
Yeah. And I want you to delete videos where my voice is in as well.
Okay. Yeah. Well, anyway, I want to thank you all for watching. And if you haven't subscribed to Jure, make sure you do. And we will speak to you guys not in the next video. No, because I will be not joined by Jure this time, I guess. But maybe in the future they will make a planet, I don't know. Something.
Prison.
Planet Prison.
Yeah.
And then we can do another collab.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.